Good morning. I'm Kristen Shelmes. This is my daughter, Lizzie. I'm kidding. She's supposed to be here, but we have so many kids in childcare this morning, and she works for childcare. So she needs to be over there, and that's a really good problem for the church to have. So she's with me in spirit. Lizzie started working in childcare this year, taking care of the babies and toddlers during the service. My son Adam did the same before he went off to college. My husband and I have been with this church since 2000. Both of my children were raised in this church. Lizzie and I were asked to talk about our personal journeys in the church and how they are different across generations. My personal journey may be different than many people who attend church. I am the self-described most church-going agnostic ever. Despite the fact that my mother and my brother are both UCC ministers, I've never really believed that anybody truly knows the answers. Religion is very hard for me to trust. So if I've had such a hard time trusting religion, why have we been here for so long and been so involved? It's because I trust the ministers, the Sunday school teachers, the children's music directors, and the wings leaders to allow my children to think and have questions about their faith. I knew that they would never be told what they must believe. I trusted the other youth to be good peers and role models for my kids, and I trusted that it would help my kids become good role models for the next generation. Lizzie is an active member of Wings and is now one of the oldest kids in the group. She's close to the oldest kid in the group. I now get to see the fruits of our investment. I see that the younger kids in church look up to her, just like she used to look up to the teens when she was a kid. I trusted that the committee involvement, service, and outreach opportunities at FCC provided would bring help and hope to other people, and would help us become better people as well. I can say with certainty that much of what my kids have learned about being good humans has come from engagement in this church. I believe that in order to lead a full life, you have to invest in something. It won't be perfect all the time, but will certainly be worth the investment. I'll admit, in my early days of being a member of this church, I took a service approach. I thought, the church exists to serve me. Why are they asking for my money and time? I was a little entitled. Thankfully, I evolved. As my kids and I started participating more, I realized that activities cost money. If I wanted us to keep having these amazing opportunities to learn and serve, I had better start contributing my time and my money. I'd say about 10 years ago, I went back to a service approach. By then, I had really matured in my thought process, though. I realized that if I loved this church and I felt like it was important, it was my job to serve the church. The church is all of us. And the church does not work unless we invest. So this morning I ask you, what can you do to invest in this church? Can you give? Can you give more? Can you serve? Can you do all of that? We are asking you to thoughtfully consider what you want this church to be, and we are asking you to invest.